Yes, in this video, we are going to see about the object-oriented programming in PHP. Before that, we'll see what are a few object-oriented concepts. Class, object, member variable, member functions, inheritance, parent class, child class, polymorphism, overloading, data abstraction, encapsulation, constructor and destructor. These, almost all these functions or methods or property together, they form the object-oriented programming. So first we'll see what is a class. A class is a data type which includes local functions as well as local data. So you create a class, within that you will declare the parameters, you can call it as a parameters and functions which operate on those parameters, okay, local data. So you can think of a class as a template from which you take so many objects, okay, create many instances of the same kind of objects. Now, if you say an example for a class, yes, you can say this as an example. A class, you give a name for the class as a student. A student can be considered as a class where many students are there. So each student will have a name, will have a roll number. This is the data type. Okay. So in order to get the data for this, we may write some functions. If we want to manipulate this, we may write some functions. That we call it as a methods. Okay. So set name will get the name for this variable. And set roll number will get the name value for this roll number. So class, in general, class is a student. Within the class, each, there will be many objects, students, there are many students. We call them as object of the class. So these are all the objects and this is a class. A class defines the general property and each objects belong to that. So here, this, she's a girl. Having the name Jenna and roll number like this, and boy having this name and roll number, etc. So this can be defined as a, together can be defined as a class. So you can define a class from which you have many instances. We can create a lot of instances like what we have seen. So a class is an object, a class is a data type which includes local function. Just now we have seen local function, set name, set roll number like that. And as well as local data, which is nothing but name, roll number. So you can think of a class as a template. So you can create one class. And when you create of the same type from that class, then we call them as an instances. Okay, so object. An individual instance of the data structure, just like we have just now, we have seen individual students, though they are all said to be objects. An individual instance of the data structure defined by a class. You define a class once, so you define only one class and then make many, you can say it's copy, and you give different name for that. So for example, many objects that belong to it. Objects are also known as instances. Okay, when you create them, you call them as an instances. Member variable, just now we have seen name, roll number. They are all said to be variable, which are defined inside the class. So member variable, these are the variables defined inside a class. This data will be invisible to the outside of the class and can be accessed via member functions. We have set name, this is the member functions, and this is the member variables which you have defined. So this can be accessed. You can assign name for this. You can give value for this variable. You can assign value for this variable and all through this member functions only. These two are unavailable outside, but they can be accessed only through the member functions. So member functions, member variable, these are the variables defined inside the class. Just now we have seen this data will be invisible to the outside of the class and can be accessed via member functions. These variables are called attribute of the object once an object is created. Member functions, these are the functions defined inside a class and are used to access the object data. Inheritance, when you define a class and you define another class, when the second class inherit the properties of the first class, okay, then we call it as an inheriting. The first class is said to be the parent, and the one which is deriving is said to be the child. So when a class is defined by inheriting the existing function of a parent class, then it is called the inheritance. Here, child class would inherit all or few member functions and variables of the parent class, just like how the children are inheriting their characters from their parents, their genes from their parents. Here also, we define a class and we define another class where the second class is inheriting from the first class. For example, here we define one bigger class, a broad class, vehicle. We call it as a vehicle. Then within vehicle, it may be a wheeled vehicle or a ship like that. Okay. So within wheel, it may be a four wheelers or a two wheelers like that. So, but anyway, whatever it is, if you say this is inheriting the properties of the vehicle. It may have a steering wheel. It will have speed. Speed is one of the thing, parameter, member variable, all those things. So if you take many of these things, they will be common to vehicles. So from vehicle, they will be inheriting. So we call it as an inheritance. So for example, class A, if it's generalized from class A, when you have defined class B, class C, class D, all these things may be inheriting something from the class A. In this case, this is said to be parent, and these are all said to be children, child. Parent class, this now we have seen a class that is inherited by another class. Okay, if it is inherited from or by another class, this is also called as base class or super class. Then a class that inherits from another class, this is also called a subclass or derived class. And polymorphism, this is an object oriented concept. This is one of, once you have defined class and object, when you keep writing your coding, you will implement these characteristics of object-oriented programming. What are they? Polymorphism, overloading, overriding, data abstraction, and encapsulation. So first we will see what is polymorphism. The name itself, many. So this is an object-oriented concept where same function will be used for different purposes. For example, function name will be the same, but you can pass different types of arguments, different size of the argument, so that it correctly find out, the compiler will correctly find out which function it is going to execute. So for example, here we have draw, the shape in a, this is a parent class where we define draw, but here it may have you depending upon the parameter we pass, it will draw a triangle, it may draw a rectangle, it may draw a circle. The name of the function is same. So for example, I want to draw a triangle, means I have to pass, say for example, I'm going to find area of a triangle. Okay, then in which case I have to pass L and H, length and height. Suppose I want to find the L and B. Here rectangle L and B I have to pass. Then for circle I have to pass the radius. So depending upon the parameter, the correct function will be executed. Even if the name is same, depending upon the argument, say for example, I may pass a floating point here, I may pass an integer, I may pass a string. So depending upon what type of argument correctly go, the compiler will correctly execute the correct functions. Then overloading, a type of polymorphism. It's also a polymorphism in which some or all of the operators have different implementation depending on the types of, that's what. Overloading is one of the type of the polymorphism. Similarly, functions can also be overloaded with a different implementation. Then data abstraction, any representation of data in which the implementation details are hidden. The implementation details will not be visible to user, but the user will know how to use that function and what are all the parameters they have to pass in order for that function to be executed. For example, even in our C++, we have in many languages, we have the built-in functions. The built-in functions, the user will not be able to see the code, implementation code, but they will know how to use it. For example, printf statement, printout or cout statement. We know that we have to pass the message along with the if we want to print any variable, how it has to be, say, for example, within double quotes, we have to pass the message, comma, then variable will be given, like that. So the user will know the correct syntax, how they have to pass the input parameter value, but they don't know how the printf statement works. They know only it will print it on the screen. Same with cout. So there are many statements, many functions, say conio.h, in conio.h we have stdio.h, all those things we have. If you take math.h, we have tan, abs, square root functions, all those things. They must also have been implemented with the same C++ code, but those codes are not visible to the user. They have no access to the they cannot access the codes. Instead, they will be knowing how to use that function. That is called abstraction, data abstraction. So the user is kept unaware of the basic implementation of a function property. The user is able to view only basic functionalities, whereas the internal details are hidden. Now, if you say that, say, for example, this is a mobile phone. In mobile phone, we have so many menus, inbox, then we have contacts. So the user will be, I'm going to create a new contact, then it will open up, and then you have to go, the user has to add, click an add button, then it will ask for the name, email ID, or phone number, then save, that's all. But how it is stored, how it works, how it gets the data and where it is stored, all those things are not visible to the user. So you have just a few buttons and inputs to use. What happens under the hood? You don't have to know, no need for us to know. So there are so many buttons like home buttons, volume button, charge button. So if I increase, if I press the volume button, how it increases, what mechanism it do, that is none of the bother for the user. He just know that he has to press it to increase the volume, that's all. So this is called abstraction. What the user know, only that will be given. So then encapsulation. Encapsulation refers to a concept where we encapsulate all the data and member functions together to form an agent. That is what? The class itself is an encapsulation, where in class we define the member variables and member functions to operate on the member variable. So you will be accessing only as an object, and then so it is a wrapping up of data and function together into a single unit is done. This feature keeps the data safe from outside interference and misuse. This leads to a concept of data hiding. So here we define a class, then we define the variables and methods. Here private instance and variables from the outside class, how it will be accessed. It will not be directly accessed. It can be accessed only through object creation, and through object we access all these things. So that is what encapsulation. So that accidentally or unaccidentally, the user will not be able to manipulate the data structure of the class which has been created. Then constructors and destructors. This is while declaring the variable itself. While declaring the class itself, if you want to initialize the values for the objects, that is called constructor. It refers to a special type of function which will be called automatically whenever there is an object formation from a class. So during the creation of the object, if you want to initialize the object, then we can go for constructor. Destructors, when the function is over and when it comes to an end, automatically it will be deleted or goes out of the scope. Now we'll see all these things we have seen just now. Inheritance also we have seen. Then method overloading. One more concept in method overloading. So what is the difference between method overloading and ordinary functions? Say you have here, this is without method overloading. Add two. We have two variables. Now we're trying to add these values. Now I want to add three values. See here, we have to write another functions. Add four means we have to write another function. But whereas in overloading, you write only one, you give only one name. Even if you write the the functions. Here also three functions are there, here also three functions are there, but here you give the same name. So you have to remember only the name and then how many parameters, what type of parameters you have to pass. Here x and y, two parameters you pass and then it will return. So when the compiler sees a function calling with two parameters, it correctly go and execute only this. It will not call these functions. If it sees a function with add with four parameters, automatically it comes here. It will not go and execute all these two functions. So that is a advantage of a method overloading. Then overriding, this we will see later when we come to the class. Okay, now we'll see how to define a class. See, we can define a class by giving the keyword CLASS. This is the keyword for defining a class. Then you give a name for that class. Here what we have given is person. So you can start with the anchor bracket, question mark and PHP. This is how we start a PHP, and then class person. Then within curly braces, you start giving the local variables and methods which operate on the local variables. Here what we have given is, we have declared a variable var1. You can declare a variable using var keyword also. Then var2 equal to, we have given some value for this. Then function, my function. This is as usual how you define in a function in the PHP. Function, you give, this is a keyword, and my function is the name of the user, what he has given for his functions. So my function. Then we pass these two argument and argument two, and then within the curly braces you define the functions and all. Okay, and some other, if anything else in the class to be declared, that also can be done. So declaration of the class can be done with the keyword class followed by a name for that. Then declaration of the members followed by declaration of the methods. This is the overall syntax of the class. So the keyword class followed by the name, all those things, whatever I have defined there, that's what here has been explained. So we will see the step-by-step process of creating a class. First, as an example, we'll see the first example, class author. So with empty, this also works without any statements also, but this is with the empty values, this class is created. Then we slowly start declaring the variable. Here variable $name, okay, add variables. Then same here we write a function, because we want to assign a value for that. You here itself you can directly assign, but if you assign, it will be only one value, always assign. So we want to assign some values from the main program. After creating objects, we want to assign values for different names for that. Then you have to use a function through which only you can access this. So set author name, we have given a function name, and then we pass some values, parameters. So this is add methods if needed, like this. Okay, then this keyword point to the current object. This already you know from Java, that this is used to point to the current object variables. Okay, both variables as well as object. So how you can assign? See here, function set author name. This is the name of the function. And then we pass some variable. And with this value, we are assigning to this name. Okay, local variable, member variable. For that member variable, we are assigning the value which you are passing. So here, so in this, we assign this input parameter, whatever the value which is passed for this, to this local parameter, local member member variables can be done by using this this variable, this keyword. So how you can use this is by like this $this, then this symbol you have to use. In Java, you will be using dot operator, but here you will be using this one hyphen followed by this greater than symbol, and then the member variable. So like this, you have to assign. Then we define another function called get author name, where we return this, okay, return the value. So you will not be, you have to return the this whatever the first you will be assigning, then assign value you can return to the main program by this $this name. Okay, now we'll see a creating of objects of this. So here as we have already seen, this can be done like a declaration of variable, declaration of member variable, member functions, and then in the main program. With this, the class is over. Here, the class is over. Then we create the object in the main program by like this. That is using the new operator, new, and then followed by the class name. So left hand side, you assign a variable. So once you do this, the Sujatha, this will become an instance of the class author. So this is an instance object of the type author. Okay, all the methods and properties in author class are built into Sujatha object. To call the this object, set author name method like this using this operator. Now how you can call this, say how you can assign values like this Sujatha, how to use this name of the variable, because name of the instance, then this symbol, this symbol, and then set author name, you have to call the member function, then you can pass variable. So once it is, now the Sujatha, the author name is assigned, because we have declared only one member variable, to that the data is passed like this. So when you call this, this will be, the Sujatha will come here, and to this local variable, that value will be assigned. So now we'll see a small program. Here all these things are HTML code creating an object. Here we have created a class author, same thing, member variable, then member functions, where we assign a value which we are passing to the member variable, and then here we are written this. So in the main program, we assign a variable in the left hand side, and then we we use the new operator to create a instance of the class author. Then you can assign values to that like this. So we call this member function. This is what I said, you can access the name, that is this, only through member functions. So here you pass that, and in the member functions we assign that to this local member function, member variables. Now how you can get that value, so like this, using the get author name. So in the get author name, what is it? It return the value assigned in that. So here you it will print the value assigned in the Sujatha class. So the output will be the name of your friend is Sujatha. This will be printed. Output will be printed. Whatever you have assigned, that is Sujatha is printed.